go. Take on John Cooper's team in State College, all Penn State. Ki-Jana Carter, immense day. 20 yards for the score, 3 first half scores for Carter, Penn State 7-0. Bobby Engram, oh, nice catch of the Collins pass. 21-0 Lions. Second quarter, it's 28-0. The Arsenal, everybody, what a catch by Mike Archie. Takes the hit and holds on. 35-0 Penn State to the locker room. Oh, they did make a mistake. They stumbled on their way into the locker room. That was about the only first half mistake for the Nittany Lions. It's now a final at Beaver Stadium. 63-14 for those who said they had to win big. Boy, did they win big. And Ki-Jana Carter had an immense defense was the story for Nebraska. The offense did fine. They established the fullback in the first half. Corey Schlesinger, 13-yard score. 7-0 Nebraska. Tom Osborne's offense with Brooke Behringer at the helm. Pretty sharp. Eric Aul for the tight end was a factor. 15 yards on this key. 3rd and 3. The same drive the entire Arsenal here. Little shovel pass to Abdul Muhammad, and the little receiver jukes his way to the one. Clinton Child scored 17-0. Cordell Stewart and Rick Neuheisel trying to get the offense in gear. Just did 3rd and 4. Michael Westbrook down the field, but Tyrone Williams, that great closing speed that the gang talked about on the kickoff show on Thursday, evident there. The final nail in the coffin. Behringer down the line of scrimmage, pulls it back, and offered a 30-yard score. Huskers led 24-0. Colorado had several opportunities to go for it on 4th down in the second half. But the pressure by Nebraska throughout the day, Terry Keneally here on this one, Dante Jones, the entire front 7 for the Black Shirts, along with a good effort from the secondary. That defensive speed showing itself in Nebraska hands Colorado its first loss. Interesting, on 3rd down, would they stay that way? They were down 14-10 early. Stephen Davis took over the 4th quarter. A 1-yard plunge here made it 17-14. Next possession, this is Auburn's bread and butter play this year. Sweep to the right, let Davis take the rest. 24 yards to make it 24-14, and later in the 4th, Davis puts the exclamation point. Have we seen this play before, folks? Coming again. 53 yards is gone for the touchdown. 246 yards, 3 touchdowns for Davis. Auburn has won 19 straight. Tigers are at 8-0. Looks like they may get to the Iron Bowl unbeaten and might find Alabama there just. Seminoles of Florida State against unbeaten Duke in Tallahassee. Welcome against the big guys, Dukies. Oh, nice fake. Danny Cannell, yeah, he still has it behind his hip. Airs it out to Kez McCorvey, 45 yards. The Seminoles at this point in the game were up 14-6. The Duke touchdown on a punt fumble, make it 21-6. Great touch to Omar Ellison, a 70-yard two-play drive. That kind of day for Fred Goldsmith's team. Then Warwick Dunn still in the 2nd quarter. Look at the moves, the speed, the 6. 32 second quarter points for the Seminoles, who win 59-20. Impressive numbers for Cannell. Kez McCorvey had 10 of those catches for 207 yards. Big back swarm. It's 9-3 Arizona in the 4th. The offense, Danny O'Neill to Josh Wilcox, 15 yards, 10-9. They're going berserk in Eugene. Next possession for the Cats. 1st and 10, Dan White looking for Lamar Lovett. Big coverage. 2nd down, Chad Cota breaks up the intended swing pass. It's 3rd down. He's going to look for Lovett again. Once again, terrific defensive coverage. Tommy's got to go for it on 4th down. Back to the wall, down 1, no timeouts, 4th quarter. White spots Carrie Taylor over the middle, but Alex Molden, you saw number 1 a lot on that series. 3 key plays behind the defense, leading the Pac-10 in turnovers forced. Oregon beats Arizona. And now if Washington State wins, we'll update their score in a second, we could have a 4-way tie at 4-1 atop the Pac-10. In the big house earlier on ESPN, Michigan was in trouble. Todd Collins, a hip pointer on the 5th play. He did return. But as you see, Wisconsin up 4 in the 3rd. Darryl Bevel to the freshman. Tony Simmons, yes, he not only got 1, but both feet down there. 24-13, 4th and goal. Collins has to go for it. Jay Reimersma in the end zone. 2-point conversion failed, a 5-point lead. Did you see that block by Ty Wheatley? He can run him and he can knock him down. But early in the 4th, Brent Moss on the ground, 106 yards. 2nd effort gets him in. Michigan taking it on the chin. 3 home losses for the first time since 1967. Who's going to get the inside lane for the Cotton Bowl? Zebby Lethbridge, this redshirt freshman for Texas Tech, they have the Red Raiders there. Nice pass to Scott Ayler and add a 2-point conversion. 21-0 Tech. Early in the 4th, it's 24-3. It's Lethbridge again, and Tony Darden's open. 44 yards down to the 1. Tech bangs it in on the next play. Yeah, you deserve to dance. And give the coach, Spike Dykes, a Gatorade bath. Big win in Lubbock for Tech, 33-9. So now Texas Tech is at 3-2. Texas is at 2-2. Came in at 7-1, but they had a tough day. A big day for Jake Plummer, the ASU quarterback. That's Keith Poole. And he's going to go the distance. 83 yards. One of three Plummer touchdown passes on the day. He threw for 327 yards. Arizona State, which used to be in the WAC, beats up on current WAC team BYU by 21. Thomas Simmons, a 35-year-old Virginia Tech, questionable call. That should not have been intentional grounding. It was called such. And this was late in the second quarter, a key play because the Canes took over in good field position. Frank Costa throws one of those balloons and the big receiver, Yatiel Green, comes down with it. They're happy in Caneland. Miami's unbeaten in the conference, improving their overall record to 6-1. Canes winning their 12th straight every meeting they've had with Virginia Tech. Next week, it's Miami and Syracuse, big one in the Big East, likely for the conference.